Krishna played many tricks, and like all small boys, he was naughty. Yashoda found it very difficult to handle the complaints that poured in. Yashoda, Krishna stole butter in my house.
Look, mother, I'm so short. The butter pot is kept so high. How could I reach it?
Krishna, you are becoming naughtier day by day. I will have to punish you.
So, she brought a piece of rope and placing Krishna by the side of the mortar, tried to tie him to it. But she found that the rope was a little short. So she got another piece and joined both the ropes.
Ma!
Still the rope was not long enough. She found that the rope was short by 2 inches to make a knot. When Krishna saw his mother perspiring and tired, he allowed himself to be tied up out of compassion for her. Leaving Krishna tied up, she went inside to resume her household. Krishna crawled slowly and he found that the mortar too was coming behind him. Gap in between them. He hit upon a plan to free himself from the mortar. He thought to himself,
if I squeeze myself through the trees to the other side, the mortar will not pass through the gap. I shall use all my strength to pull the mortar. The rope will then snap and I can free myself.
He pulled the mortar, but the rope did not snap as he expected. Again he tried with all his strength, but instead of the rope snapping, the two trees fell to the ground with a great crash. miracle followed. Two celestial beings came out from those trees.
We are the sons of Kubera. Narada has cursed us to become trees for our misdeeds. He also said that the touch of Krishna would deliver us from the curse.
Saying so, the celestial beings bowed to Krishna and left. Hearing the loud noise, Yashoda rushed to the spot. She was amazed to see the two trees and Krishna playing happily by their branches. She couldn't understand how little Krishna uprooted such big trees which were there for so many years.
Krishna, as usual, went towards the river Yamuna with his friend.